located in the western part of the continent. The Iberian Peninsula is made up of Spain, Portugal, and Gibraltar, and has some of the most unique forests on the planet. Cork oak and its close relative, the holm oak, are the dominant tree species. They're evergreen, with thick leathery leaves that are hardy enough to survive the region's mild winters. But more crucially, these leaves are designed to conserve water in the 35-degree summer heat. An open canopy allows for a mosaic of habitats, rich with woody shrubs and blankets of aromatic herbs. This complex habitat is essential to one of the most elusive animals on the planet. The ancestor of the Iberian lynx lived in North America before migrating to Eurasia across exposed land bridges millions of years ago. Through isolation during glacial periods, it diverged into the two European species that we know today. At only 15 kilograms, the Iberian lynx is half the weight of its better-known Eurasian cousin, yet three times as heavy as a domestic cat. It's found nowhere else but the Iberian Peninsula, and is restricted to tiny pockets of Spain and Portugal. It's evolved to have a smaller body and shorter fur, enabling it to cope with the heat of the region. The Iberian lynx is a solitary creature. Throughout summer, their daily movements are tied to areas where few water sources still remain. Much like the African savanna, these water holes are a magnet to life. The European rabbit is a vital part of the region's food chain, supporting around 40 predators, from eagles to snakes. They take shelter in these scrubby forests, venturing into clearings to seek out their diet of grasses. Their digestive system is perfectly designed to extract nutrients and moisture from vegetation. By re-ingesting their softer droppings, known as cecotrophs, they can extract up to 80% of the plant's protein, as well as vitamins and minerals. Yet in summer, food alone isn't enough to quench their thirst. This male lynx knows that where there's water, there'll be food. Iberian lynx's speciality is rabbit. He needs to eat one a day to survive. His ears move independently of each other to channel the softest of sounds made by a rabbit's padded paws. Here, the lynx's specialized hunting strategy comes into play. It can't match the rabbit's speed. They can run at over 50 kilometers an hour. But the thick foliage complements his mottled fur, allowing him to stealthily gain ground, camouflaged from his intended victim. decisive pounce and a prolonged bite to the throat is all it takes. The existence of the Iberian lynx is inextricably linked with these rabbits, which make up over 80% of their diet. Though rabbits are known to breed rapidly, in the last 70 years, their populations have been decimated through outbreaks of disease. When rabbit numbers fall, so do the lynx. This is one of the main reasons why the Iberian lynx is the most endangered cat in the world. Today, there are only around 400 individuals roaming the peninsula. In this parched landscape, the Iberian lynx lives day to day. This hunter must execute the search and stalk process tomorrow, once again. Despite its small population, Iberian lynx numbers are on the increase. In a handful of areas, they're successfully breeding. Cubs are born in spring. Females usually give birth to three or four within a secluded den, often a large tree hollow. But usually only two will make it beyond weaning age. At 10 weeks old and fully weaned, this pair have beaten the odds. But life remains hazardous. Their mother has relocated them to new den sites several times since they were born to reduce the risk of parasite infection. They won't venture far from the safety of the thickets. Timed perfectly to coincide with peak rabbit populations, their hunting instincts are kicking in. However, these two aren't quite sure what to do with the potential meal they've found. Like many cats, they revel in playing with their food. Fortunately, their mother will continue to provide for them for the time being. But in around 10 months, they'll have learned enough to fend for themselves. Innocent playthings for now, but fearsome predators in years to come.